Hi, I'm Dylan, and back there is my cat, Penny. I'm a writer and a web developer, and this channel is called No Categories. It's about writing and technology. In this video, let's take a look at an app called NovelAI. It's a writing app that uses artificial intelligence to help you write stories. Let's take a look at what it can do. In their own words, what even is NovelAI? It offers a natural language processing playground with AI models trained on real literature. The AI seamlessly adapts to your input. You can fine-tune the output with a range of settings. You can export your work for backup and sharing. The developers strongly emphasize privacy and freedom of speech. More on that later. I've been using NovelAI off and on since it launched a couple years ago. I've been impressed with what it can do. At times, it can feel like you're really collaborating with it. For the basics, you have a writing space, and whenever you like, the AI can add to what you've written. You can revise the inputs and continue writing until you're happy with the result. You can choose from a set of AI models, each one tuned to write in a different way. NovelAI's modules add refinements to the writing process, like writing styles, thematic elements, and inspiration from example texts. Because AI writing apps often have the memory of a goldfish, they forget things after about 7 pages. NovelAI helps you compensate for this with a memory section, where you can enter details that it should not forget. This is really helpful with things like characters, settings, and plot. You can also give NovelAI instructions called author notes. This is similar to a movie director encouraging an actor. You can save the author notes in the memory, or you can add them in line with the text for more spontaneous changes. NovelAI has the ability to generate images, and I'm not particularly interested in it, but I'll mention it later. For the most advanced level of control, you can even use NovelAI to train your own AI model. You could train the AI to write the way that you do, based on your own examples. I tested NovelAI by writing 2 stories. First, I tried writing a high school drama, starting from one of the built-in templates. I had a general idea of where I wanted the story to go. I wanted to tell a story about an unlikely pair of prom dates. NovelAI introduced a plot twist. The unlikely pair began because of a dare, as a joke, and a secret. Even though a real romance did develop, the secret remained as a source of tension and drama. Interesting stuff. My other experiment was mostly a test of NovelAI's configuration options. I entered a setting, a Gilded Age hotel, and some prompts for characters. In an early draft, NovelAI insisted that I should add ghosts and other fantastical elements. Despite my personal preference for literary realism, we compromised and arrived at some magical realism. Surreal, cult-like behavior involving the telephone network in the hotel, and fine, a ghost. I mentioned that NovelAI emphasizes privacy and freedom of speech, which is great. But the user community is obsessively fanatic about this at times. Privacy and freedom of speech are inescapable subjects on the Reddit and Discord communities, to the detriment of very much conversation about writing, in my opinion. Well, yes, you should be free to write whatever you want in your own privacy. There. Done. Can we move on now? I know it's not that simple, unfortunately, but I'll move on anyway. There's another thing you can't escape. I mentioned that NovelAI can generate images, and from what I can tell, the purpose of this is to generate images of hot anime babes. Again, fine, do whatever you want, but I just want to write. Hot anime babes with ridiculous proportions are a distraction. An utter distraction, you might say. I really like the advanced settings in NovelAI, but they're still a bit confusing to me. There is an official tutorial, and there's an independently written wiki that does a great job. There are some excellent guides on Reddit. Still, for my money, I'd like to see more documentation. succinct video tutorials, or any more official guidance. And speaking of money, there's a free trial of NovelAI, but to get the whole set of features, you'll spend $25 a month. That's more than it costs for Spotify, Netflix, or Amazon Prime, and about what you'd pay for ChatGPT Plus. Before I get to the conclusion here, I'd like to open the conversation up. I bet somebody out there has more experience with this thing than I do, and I think we'd all benefit from hearing about that. Or if you have any questions about it or any observations, let's hear it in the comments. So, in conclusion, is NovelAI worth it? I think it could be for a month or so, every once in a while. I tend to save my workout and then let my subscription lapse, and then pick it back up again whenever there's a new writing feature. NovelAI's language models and modules can help you create unique and interesting stories. I think it's great that you can build your own model with this, and while there are some confusing settings, it's a nice interface and it's not too tricky to learn. The price may be a bit steep at $25 a month, but you do get a lot of features. Overall, I recommend giving NovelAI a try.